Hello everyone, good morning, good evening. My name is Asit. I'm the host and panelist for this webinar. And we have almost reached the end of the year. This is the last webinar for ADM service for this year. And before we begin, I hope all of you are taking due care in this pandemic. And before starting, let's ensure that we have the housekeeping sorted. For best audio experience, you need to connect on computer audio. If you cannot still hear us, you can just check your system volume settings. And if you have any questions during the webinar, feel free to type in your questions in the question section too. We'll try to answer the questions as and when we find time. And this is a recorded webinar. We'll be sharing the recordings of the webinars shortly after. My name is Hasit and I'm the host and panelist. I've been conducting ADM service monthly webinars for about a year now. And I have with me Dario, who is from Citrix IT network team. And today it's a very exciting webinar wherein you will directly hear from the horse's mouth how Citrix IT has been able to leverage ADM service to bring down their efforts that they used to spend in managing the various ADC instances. It's a very interesting use case, a very huge deployment environment. And Dario will talk about all those challenges and how ADM service has helped in mitigating each of those challenges. So this is the agenda for this month's webinar. We'll start off with overview of ADM service as usual. We'll talk about the various license tier. We'll talk about advantages of moving to ADM service and some of the feature differentiation with respect to ADM on-prem. And then I will hand it over to Dario, who will talk about Citrix IT's ROI use case from ADM. And then I will talk about the next two use cases, which is around app usage analytics using machine learning and app CPU analytics and insights. And these two use cases have been very recently introduced in ADM service. So let's get started and feel free to type in your questions as you may have. So let's see how we can jumpstart to ADM service in three quick steps. It's very easy. Your first step is you need to have an account in Citrix Cloud. Some of you may be already having an account. In that case, you just need to sign in with your Citrix Cloud account. And the next step, you have a couple of options to deploy your agent. You can either deploy your agent on-prem on any hypervisor, or you can deploy your agent on a public cloud, or you can select a fastest method of onboarding, which is using the built-in agent. And built-in agent as a methodology is available for all ADC instances which are on version 12.0, 56.20 onwards. And after you select the built-in agent, you just need to log into your ADC console. You can use PuTTY or any similar tool. Navigate to a specified folder. We'll share the docs link which has the details of the folder. From within the folder, you need to call the built-in agent script. Pass on the admin credentials and the service URL and the activation code. And the service URL and the activation code you can find on the ADM service GUI when you select the built-in agent method. And with that, you are done. So within these quick three steps, you'll get onboarded to ADM service. And later, you can deploy one or more additional agents on a hypervisor and add them to ADM service to leverage the full suite of capabilities. Now let's have a look at some of the advantages of moving to ADM service. It's very easy to operate, as we saw. You can get started in three quick steps and you always get the latest feature updates. So ADM service has a feature release happening once in every 2 weeks versus 6 weeks for ADM on-prem. And you don't have to worry about managing your ADM deployments because it's a cloud-based solution. So there is no hassle of maintaining your ADM as a HA pair as a HA or managing the DR for your ADM instances. Faster time to value. You get started with few clicks. No requisite of buying any license to explore the solution, which we'll see. ADM service has a freemium tier called ADM Service Express, using which you can explore the solution. You don't have to purchase the license to explore the solution as such. And it supports state-of-the-art advanced machine learning use cases. So we have been adding a lot of ML-based use cases every quarter. We started off with a ML-based use cases on anomalous server response time, which will highlight if any of the servers in your any of the backend servers in your server farm has a very high response time and is seeing an anomaly. Machine learning models will learn from the server response time and pinpoint such anomalies. We have now added more machine learning based capabilities around app usage analytics. and around predicting CPU and memory usage for ADC instances for next 24 hours. Lower operating expense because you don't spend any resources or any effort in managing your ADM instances, which helps you save down your operating expenses. And it can support any kind of deployment, however complex it is, whether your ADCs are on public cloud or an on-prem or a hybrid combination of both public cloud and on-prem. And it can support any kind of applications, whether your applications are traditional monolithic applications or modern day microservices based application. Now let's have a look at some of the feature advantages of ADM service vis-a-vis ADM on-prem. So as I spoke, a server response time anomaly, this is ML based use cases, and this is available only on ADM service. It will help you to highlight any backend server where the response time is becoming anomalous. Similarly, CPU and memory predictions for next 24 hours, the model will learn last 7 days of data and will help you to predict your CPU and memory usage for next 24 hours so that you can take any kind of intervening actions if required. App peak analytics helps you to point out any kind of peak usage of the applications over a period of time. And app lean usage analytics will give you top 5 lean usage duration of your applications and by across the dimensions of requests or throughput, and using which you can plan a maintenance schedule, maintenance or downtime of your applications. And we have a lot of ML based indicators for app security. I will paste the doc link which talks about all the different ML based indicators. Some of the examples are pinpointing any kind of unusually high download volume or unusually high upload volume on your applications. So using machine learning, the model learns and throws up all these kind of anomalous events. And today we'll see these two use cases, which are around app usage analytics using machine learning and app CPU analytics. And we have a planned SSL certificate issuance and renewal with respect to WinAFI integration, which is planned tentative for Q1 21. So this helps you to gauge how ADM service is adding a lot of additional capabilities with respect to ADM on-prem. And we'll see with time more and more features being becoming exclusive to ADM service. Now see, let's see how we can get started on ADM service. So as I told, you don't need to buy any solution to explore, buy any licenses to explore the solution. You can always get started on the Express tier. It is a freemium version, meaning thereby that you get access to a limited set of functionalities in terms of 2 virtual servers for analytics, network functions and network reporting. You get 2 config jobs and 2 stylebook config tags. And there is a data retention limit of 500 MB or 1 day of data, whichever is lesser. So these are the only limitations. Having said that, the good thing is that there is no time based limitation as such. You can explore the solutions for as long as you want before making a purchase decision. Now, once you have explored the solution and you're convinced about the value proposition, you can then move to the advanced license for full set of capabilities, which will be around exploring analytics features and capabilities by licensing virtual servers to explore SGX Insight for gateway ICA traffic, Gateway Insight for any insights pertaining to your Citrix gateways, web and SSL Insight for web applications, and security insights. And you get unlimited storage with separate storage queue. So by default, ADM service gives 0.5 GB of storage for every license bought. So let's say you buy 100 licenses, you get 50 GB of storage by default. Now, if your storage limitation exceeds 50 GB, there are additional standalone storage queues which you can buy to supplement your storage needs. And you are not limited by any management monitoring automation capabilities. You get unlimited config jobs, unlimited stylebook config packs. So this is the advantage you get by moving to the advanced license for full set of capabilities. With that, I will now hand over to Dario, who will speak about Citrix IT's use case, what were the challenges, how the deployment environment was very extensive, and how in each of the use cases ADM service helped mitigated those challenges. Over to you, Dario.
Hello, everyone. So my name is Roman Dario Lopez Gonzalez. I'm like the network architect over here at Citrix IT, in charge of all the Citrix network technology. So today I would like to go ahead and give you a brief overview of First of all, our environment and a couple of benefits that ABM has brought out to us. So let's start by just saying that we have like several data centers. So we have four on-prem data centers, and we have also just workloads deployed on Azure and AWS. And more recently, we are just trying GCP. We have support over 50 offices, five of which are considered like global campuses for our infrastructure. And all our systems support and provide services for more than 8,000 employees, multiple partners, and customers as well. Our production environment is like built over 150 Citrix ADCs, and we support over 1,000 applications globally on the dark. So it's like really a big environment, at least for our deployment. It's an enterprise-grade environment, which we go ahead and we manage all today through ADM. In the past, we used to just like manage everything locally and you know, going through the ADC and perform all the tasks. We are going to show you in a couple of minutes over there how much time we used to spend on that task and how much time right now we just spend right now over there. So we would like to add as well that today while we use ADM, we have a lot of benefits over there that we are going to be covering in a second. Some of those and the most critical ones that we are taking leverage today and we're working with the ADM product team to improve and performance is the machine learning. In the past, we used to take a long time to detect where an issue was or just mostly to troubleshoot an issue over there that some of the times or most of the times is it end up being a backend server replying as well. So machine learning helps with that a lot. You could easily go through just like your analytics on your application, and you could see that the load balancer is replying correct. And when you get a phone call of somebody, hey, I have performance issue to my load balancer, you could easily go to ADM, just like see what load balancer they are talking about and see that, hey, your application is slow because you have a problem with backend server number five. So please go ahead and correct that, and that will be just your root cause over there. So let's go ahead and let's move a little bit forward. So let's talk about some of the challenges that we were facing before ADM, right? So one of those, and I think that the most critical ones that was taking a lot of time, it was like to perform the regular day-to-day tasks, right? And what I mean is like upgrades and backups. So upgrades on our infrastructure, as you can imagine, infrastructure of our size, we require upgrading like several HA pairs, and not only several HA pairs on a single location, but in several locations at the same time. We have like just a pretty fast turnaround time when it comes to upgrades. Sometimes we are asked by the product team to, hey guys, can you help us just to test this new build before it gets released to the customers? Or just even like, hey, we want to use this new feature that we ask the product team, and they provide us a build with that feature over there. So we have to upgrade several environments at the same time to test that. So performing that in the past, it used to be like really, really long time. It used to take sometimes days, not even weeks, depending if it was a global upgrade of all our infrastructure. Right now, it's really, really quick, and we have spent minimal time on just doing those tasks. App performance issues. As I was mentioning to you, like most of you should always get the call, hey, my ADC is performing slow. I have like some performance issues, like the NetScaler is having some issues. You spend like a lot of time, you take a lot of traces, you go ahead and you go call Citrix support, and Citrix support points you out, hey, your server number 10 on the pool is acting slow, and this is why. You have a high time for first byte over there, and out of the sudden you tell that to the owner of that service, and oh yeah, we have something over here, let us remove it and we'll fix it later. So that's something that ADM helped us tremendously over there. So app security issues. Right now we are just going ahead and we are implementing WAF, we're implementing bug management as well on our infrastructure, all from ADM, which has improved and has helped us to understand a lot of attacks that we were getting into our public-facing applications that we were not aware of and we didn't have any idea. And not only that, it also gives an idea on how to go ahead and how to mitigate those and how to prevent those from happening. So, lack of automation. In the past, when we had to perform any configuration in a set of ADCs, let's say that we want to change the LDAP authentication for the user, right? Well, the admin user, we want to refresh that password and we want to change that password on the ADC. We used to have to log in into every single individual ADC or to write a lot of complex commands on like a server or something to go ahead and just perform that task. That's something that today is built in with ADM and we could get done in a matter of minutes rather than like hours or days, depending on the task. Lack of visibility on the global performance or the global health of the ADC was something like really good for us. We didn't have a way. We knew that we were having some link drops on this ADC, that we may be having some like hard disk space on this other ADC, but we didn't have an easy way of just going to one dashboard and tell, hey, show me all the problems that we have. That's something that we didn't have, and today we could do easily with ADM. So lack of consistent configuration was something that was like playing a role over there, critical role in our hardware. We didn't have an easy way of standardizing config, meaning somebody will go to ADC number 10, they just do the configuration the way that they think, but by the time that they get to ADC number 100, they may just like go ahead and mistakenly just change something on the configuration because most of that configuration used to be done manually. Other stuff is like we had multiple teams sometimes or multiple administrators performing the configuration. And sometimes they even just like go ahead and do the configuration, even though that is the same, they don't use the same naming convention, they don't use all that. So standardization was like a real pain for us. Right now it's ADM. We could just not only push configuration automatically to the ADC, but also make sure that we keep that consistent over there. So with all that being said, so let's go ahead and let's talk about the main use cases that we use ADC for. So sorry, ADM for. First of all, it's monitoring. We monitor the ADC configuration and all the ADC health parameters. For automation, we just take care of upgrades, application deployment using Starbucks. If you haven't used Starbucks, my recommendation is try to start getting around it. We have been able to just to simplify application deployment time from a matter of like weeks sometimes to just a matter of hours. We have been able to offload all the application deployment from the Netter team all the way to the application owner. So today, if they want to go ahead and they want to deploy an application, they could go by themselves and they could do any configuration to the application. If they want to change it in the future, they could go ahead and they could do all that self-service without any interaction from the networking team. A couple of other stuff that we use for automation is we use reporting tools. We just like when we need to, especially on COVID, when we wanted to get some reports on stuff about like how much bandwidth or how much traffic we were going through, we had to use Netter reports heavily up there. So we use those on as-needed basis when we want to get some different reports about performance or metrics within the ADC. And as I mentioned, application security and especially SSL certificates management as well. So for troubleshooting, we use like the application dashboard for the application performance, and for security, we use like the analytics for security analytics over there for WAF and bot and all the machine learning capabilities that are built in into ADM service today. So let's go ahead and let's talk about a little bit how much time and how we have been saving money, because time is money in today's day. So we were able to, we just like went ahead with the product team. We did a math over there, how much it takes one upgrade, and then we just multiply that by how many amount of like events we had on a year, and that just gives us a number of 440 hours that we spent yearly. We used to spend yearly for upgrades. So with ADM today, we are able just to take all that to 12 hours. Why? Because like when you're going to go ahead and perform an upgrade today, you just like go ahead, schedule it, and you forget about it. You don't have just to go ahead, take an engineer, be on the phone with support over there, troubleshooting or making sure that the upgrade goes right. No, you just like go ahead, just let that engineer just schedule it and you forget about it. Same for the other tasks over there. So you, as you could see over there, the effort that was taking us with without IDM was like really long hours to just be able just to get any of like the different use cases that we have over here. With ADM, as you could see, we have been able just to save tremendously amount of time just of getting all those tasks done over there. So let's go ahead, let's take a summary over there. So after going through the ROI calculator that Asit and the product team has been able to pull through, we were able just to determine that we were able to save a total of like, this is the total time that we're spending today with ADM. As you could see, we were spending like over 10,000 hours a year that requires multiple engineers assigned to multiple tasks to be able just to complete all that. Today, we could get that done not even faster, but also with less engineers. So operationally speaking, we were able to save 93% of the time that we spend on the operations of my ABC infrastructure. Right now, I could just have my network engineers spending time on just like working on more design, more implementations rather than troubleshooting or operating the environment per se. So let's go ahead and let's take a look on how Citrus IT is leveraging ADM service for managing our infrastructure, right? It's going to be a couple of screenshots over here. So this is like, as I was telling you, this is how we could easily take a look into all our ADCs. We could go ahead and we could just use like the infrastructure analytics, and we could see that we have some ADCs over here that are, they are not on green state, meaning that these ADCs may be having, whether they are short of their space or they may have some issues that we need to go ahead and we need to address. So our team could easily come here and instead of like checking 150 ADCs, right now they have to just check like five, they have to check eight ADCs only. So that's something that saves a lot of time. So we were talking about application deployment, right? With Starbucks, as you can see, we have like four Starbucks for all our application owners. They could, if they need to deploy an application that requires multiple ports load balancing, they could come here. If they need to deploy a content switching, they could come here and just do all that by themselves. All this automation is built in with an ADM with no user interaction. You could just take the advantage of using the default Starbucks that are on ADM, or as we do, you could customize your Starbucks to just fit your needs better. So this is something that we were talking about, application performance, right? We could see that this application was at some point on November 14 was 100%, but something happened over here that lower the application score over there. If we go ahead and we drill down into that application, we were able to determine that the impact to this application was with, for that same reason that I was telling you before, one of the backend server was replying slow over there. With ADM, we were able just to spot that just within a matter of just getting into the dashboard and just without any trace or any other interaction, we were able to spot that. So with all that being said, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to just like send that back to Asit. I hope that you have enjoyed that. And if you have any questions, feel free to just put it on the question panel. I will be doing my best to help them. That's it.
Thanks. Bye. Thanks, Dario, for that wonderful presentation. We have a poll question and we'll get approximately 30 seconds for you to answer. So this is for you to reply with yes and no. If you believe ADM, if you deploy in your environment, can give you significant ROI for your networks team. You get 30 seconds for this poll. So we'll close the poll. It seems around more than 80% of you believe that ADM can give you significant savings. And we have a ROI calculator and we can help you gauge what sort of benefits you'll get by moving to ADM. You just need to fill in some deployment details of your environment, and the calculator will give you potential savings that you can get. Right, with that, I will now take control and I will move to the next section, which is around app usage analytics. All right, so we'll talk about this new use case, which is around app usage analytics using machine learning. So before we start, let's understand what we mean by app usage. So here we are referring to app throughput, request per second, and app data volume, these facets of the usage. And there are many scenarios wherein you would want to assess if any of the usage parameters is seeing an abnormal pattern, abnormal increase and decrease. And we'll just look at how ADM can help you assess this use case. So let's say if there are multiple applications deployed on one ADC and one of the applications is seeing a huge usage anomalous increase and it is trying to hog all the resources on that ADC. So this could lead to an ADC license limit breach, which you can see more details on the infrastructure analytics that gives you any kind of ADC capacity breach which is happening. And app usage analytics will highlight which of these applications is seeing an anomalous increase and which is leading to overall increase of ADC capacity. And then you can put any kind of rate limiting policies to throttle the incoming requests if the baseline increase is not what is the expected behavior. So this is use case number one. In the second use case, you would want to assess apps which are very volatile in nature. So let's say there is an application which sees like more than 15 to 20 incidents of increase or decrease in usage in a very short span of time, let's say 24 hours. So these apps are very volatile usage and they're very good candidates for being deployed on public cloud to be able to leverage functionalities of autoscale, which Citrix ADC also supports, and over a flexible ADC licensing model like pooled licensing. So these applications are, they would want to leverage these kind of functionalities which are available in autoscale functionality in public cloud or pool licensing. The third use case is when the app usage deviation occurs after a major event. The event could be an app code rollout has happened, or the app was taken for a scheduled maintenance and then brought back, or any kind of app or ADC level failure. So you may want to correlate these kind of events with the actual app usage deviation. So let's say you took a downtime of the application, and post that you are seeing that the app usage is showing a lot of deviation from the normal baseline. ADM will highlight all such deviations on app dashboard, and then you get a preliminary analysis that maybe this could have happened because of the recent downtime or recent change to the application which has happened, and you may want to debug further. So with that, I want to show you how it looks on the ADM interface. So this is my request per second. As you can see, the trend was fairly stable, and the blue ribbon indicates the expected range of this metric, which is request per second. And whenever this metric exceeds the expected range, as indicated by the red dots here, it is thrown up as an anomaly, and it gives more details on hover. Here we see the average request per second is 19. The expected range was in the range of 12 to 16, and the request per second exceeded the expected range by around 19%, and that's why it throws up as an anomaly. Same for data volume. We see the expected range was between 0 to 400 GB, and there are some data points in which it is exceeding the expected range. That's why these anomalous points are highlighted. We get similar data points for the throughput as well. With that, I will now move to a new use case which has been recently introduced. It is about getting the CPU usage at a per application level. Similar to app usage, like there could be instances where multiple applications are deployed on one ADC and one of the application is hogging all the CPU resources of that ADC, and the overall CPU consumption might increase. And this increase in the CPU consumption, you can get this as an alert on infrastructure analytics. However, you would want to understand which is that specific application which is responsible for overall CPU increase, and you may want to manage or throttle its traffic accordingly. And so because this specific particular application has a different traffic pattern, which could be leading to a high CPU increase. So CPU usage per application is now one of the new indicators which is available in the app score, and it contributes to a negative app score. It brings down the app score just like the other indicators which are available, be it a CPU usage on the ADC or any kind of high response time. So this is another indicator which brings down or impacts the application score. And if the CPU usage exceeds a specific threshold, the app score is negatively impacted. And this threshold has two limits. It has a lower limit and a upper limit which you can configure, and anything which falls outside that will impact the app score. And this is a configurable value, and this has been recently introduced in ADC, and therefore ADM now provides this visibility around CPU usage of the application. So as I was telling this, you get to configure the various parameters for your app score. Earlier you could configure memory on the ADC as well as the ADC CPU usage, and now additionally we have added the app CPU usage. So overall, maybe at an ADC level, you might not be breaching this limit, but one of the applications could be breaching this limit, which is when this will also throw up this indicator at a per app level. So this is my sample application. So here, in addition to the other performance issues like low session reuse or ADC memory usage, I get an app CPU usage issue, and it highlights number of occurrences within a specific duration of 1 month. 3.2k occurrences have occurred, time of last occurrence of these issues, and it gives more granular details like when did this issue occur and where, by how much percent it has exceeded the configured threshold. So these are the use cases I wanted to cover. So we saw three use cases. We talked about the return on investment, how Citrix IT is able to leverage using ADM service, and we saw app usage analytics over machine learning and app CPU analytics. We'll now move to some closing session of this webinar. So we have now introduced an NPS within the product. So this will be available for any customer who has his first login before 15th of October. And the whole idea is to capture your feedback on this, on the product. It could be around feature, it could be around documentation, around pricing, or any whatever help you need from within the product, and you are not able to, whatever gaps you see in the product. So we highly recommend you to whosoever is seeing this survey, please rate us on a scale of 0 to 10, with 10 being the highest. And once you rate, you also get a free text area wherein you can put in additional remarks on what we can do to improve this product. And the product team is very actively listening to the NPS comments, and we'll work on our best to keep the customers happy. So do give in your feedback. And we have also introduced four guided workflow. So based on our interaction with customers and our assessment, we have found that at times it becomes little difficult in terms of navigating within the product and getting to the use case very fast, or getting some sort of guidance on how do you get to the value proposition fast. So keeping that in mind, we have launched four guided workflow tours. The first is a full ADM tour, which talks about, which nearly touches upon all the core use cases of ADM. And the second one is a guided tour, which pertains mainly to the network admin, and it covers all the key management monitoring use cases, be it managing events on your ADCs or SSL certificates on your ADCs, getting any kind of notifications, or any kind of ADC infra management. So it talks about that, maintenance jobs for upgrading your ADC instances in bulk. Similarly, the third guided tour is for Gateway and SDX admin, which will talk about how you can get all work from home analytics for Gateway users, any kind of errors that the Gateway users might be facing, their details of their active and terminated sessions. And the fourth guided tour is for the application admins and the SREs who would want to see any kind of app performance, usage, and security related use cases. These guides are available as part of the first time user experience and can be launched anytime from within the product. I will show you how you can launch it from within the product. And this is what it will look like as part of your first time user experience. When you see this, you can choose any of these three icons which are showing based on what use case you want to explore. And you can also click on this downward blue arrow on the bottom right part of your screen, this outward arrow, and it will give you those list of four options on those guided tour. So So as I was saying, this is on the outward arrow, and when you click on get started, you can get to see any of those guided tour. Let's say I'm interested in Workflow Analytics for Gateway users. I click on that, so it will guide me step by step. I click on Analytics. Then it talks about SDX Insight, how we can get end-to-end performance data for any kind of SDX traffic. We can troubleshoot latency issues by pinpointing to the exact part of the network where the latency is happening, either on the client side or on the server side or on the backend ICA servers. We can analyze any kind of errors which the users might be facing on accessing the Citrix Gateway, either API errors, authentication, single sign-on errors, authorization errors, or any kind of app launch failures. And finally, it guides you how you can get these analytics by going to the accounts, subscriptions, and configuring analytics. And you can also view additional tour from here by clicking on this additional tour. Yeah, you get to see these options, and I can again choose another tour, which could be around managing Citrix ADC and Gateway. So it will take me to that relevant tour. So do explore this guide. We have kept in mind all the core users of the product and try to cover as much use cases as possible. And I will just quickly launch the other two polls which are there and answer the few questions before closing the webinar. So the first poll is for the new app usage analytics using machine learning. So we're able to highlight any kind of usage deviation. Do let us know if you find this use case useful and whether it will be relevant in your environment. You get 30 seconds for this. So more than 85% of you believe that this will be really helpful. So thanks for endorsing the use case. We'll now go to the next use case, which is around app CPU analytics. Let us know if you find this useful. You get 30 seconds for this poll. So more than 90% of you believe that app CPU analytics will be really helpful to you. So that's all we had to cover in this webinar. We'll try to answer the questions, unanswered questions. And if you have any queries, also feel free to type in your queries in the question section. And then we'll close it. So I have pasted in the chat window a YouTube video, which is a step-by-step video which talks about the built-in agent use case. The steps are very self-explanatory in the video. Do give it a look if you want to explore ADM service and quickly get started. Also pasted is the docs link, which talks about how do you deploy and what ports do you need. Also, we'll paste it in the chat window. I think we have answered most of the questions. Thank you for joining, and we'll see you in next year with some new topics. We are working on two types of new advisory service around upgrade and security advisory for your Redis instances, and there'll be more topics covered around SSL certificate automation. So that's all in this webinar. Thank you, and have a great holidays, happy holidays, and a very exciting and great new year. Thanks to all of you.